Hello everyone, this is Divya Lakshmi and today we are going to see a new topic, a very basic grammar topic, that is question tag. Without making any further delay, let's go for the presentation now. Here is your presentation, starts like this, and then question tag. We all know what is question, but we might not know what is a question tag. So to clarify that, here is a question. What is a question tag? So the answer is, a question tag is a small question at the end of a statement. So actually, after a statement, at the end of that particular statement, we will be using a very small question, that is called as a question tag. And the second one is, the question tags are used when asking agreement or confirmation. Whenever you want to ask for a confirmation or whether they agree with our statement or not, at that time we will be using this question tag. Let's go with the next slide. So there are two types of question tags. One is positive question tag and another one is negative question tag. There is a very small difference between this positive and negative question tag, that is no or not. The word no or not, if a statement is having no or not, so the question tag will be written in positive. When the statement doesn't have this no or not, then the question tag will be written in negative. That is, that question tag will include either no or not. Let's see, like as the slides go on, you might even understand it better. So you can see on the desktop, on the screen, you can see there are certain, you know, small clouds of questions. Had you, must we, would you, were they, was he. So these are, you know, had is an auxiliary, must is a modal auxiliary, would is a modal auxiliary, were is an auxiliary, and was is an auxiliary. So what is the difference between this? Actually, question tags are created with the auxiliaries. This is point number one. Point number two, there are two types of auxiliaries. One is primary and another one is modal. Okay, one is primary auxiliary and another one is modal auxiliary. So the third point, what are the primary auxiliaries we have? We have three subdivisions of primary auxiliary. One is be verb, second is do verb, third one is have verb. So be verb is am, is, are, was, were. Do verb is do, does, did. And then have verb is have, has, had. So with these primary auxiliaries, we can create questions. So for that, I had given an example of was he, were they. And the next one, modal auxiliaries. As we all know, modal auxiliaries are will, would, shall, should, can, could, may, might, and must. Even that modal auxiliary has a subdivision, that is quasi-modal or semi-modal. The quasi-modal or semi-modals are ought to, need to, dare to, and used to. Are these are only the modal auxiliaries or the positive question tag? No. For that, I had given, these are some of the examples that we can consider as positive question tags. So, will you, do you, are you, was he, were they, is he, had you, did you, should you, would you, could you, must we, and then can you, and finally have you. These are some of the examples of positive question tag. So let's go on with the next one, the negative question tags. So here you can very well see the auxiliaries carry a no or not. The auxiliary is carried, the term not. With the contraction. So, hadn't you, mustn't we, wasn't he, wouldn't you, weren't they. So, these are some of the examples I had given for negative tags. So, won't you, don't you, aren't you, and then just he, sorry, isn't he, didn't you, shouldn't you, couldn't you, and can't you, finally, haven't you. So, these are some of the examples I have given for the negative question tag. So, let's see how it is formed in a sentence, in a statement. So, here, when the statement is positive, it will carry a negative question tag. And when the statement is negative, the question tag will be in positive. So, that is a clear explanation of that construction. So, here I had given an example sentence. You are a student. The question tag formed here is aren't you. So, you is given in red, R is given in yellow. And let's see how it takes the form. You as a subject, R is the verb. And then these two verbs will be intertwisted. That is, the verb will be stated first and then the subject. So the R is an auxiliary verb that is, has been, you know, shifted in the, that has been used in the question tag. And the R, that is a verb. Not is the negative word used to create the negative question tag, and then you the subject. So here subject verb, when the question tag is created, it's verb and subject. Okay, yes. So next we'll move to the next slide. Here is your example sentences. So they want to come. So what will be the answer then? They want to come. The answer is don't they. Here there is no auxiliary verb. So when there is no auxiliary verb in a sentence, you have to consider that after the subject we have the verb do or does or did. Okay, so you can very well read the sentence by using do or don't. See, they do want to come. So now the question tag has been created as don't they. So the next one is they won't be there. So here they is the subject, won't is the verb. And here you can very well see the statement that the sentence is given in negative. So the question tag has to be in positive. So let's take the they there and divide that won't as will plus not is equal to won't. So this is the construction of that particular word, will plus won't. So what might be the answer now? The answer might be will they. Let's see the answer whether it is correct or not. Wow, that's great, that's correct. Okay, so likewise you can also practice on online. You have so many practice sheets given for the question tag. Kindly go through it and have a great day. Thank you.